awake just to hear you schwitzing.
Do you like this?
This I wore during that video for Don't Wanna Miss a Thing that Diane Warren wrote.
My favorite song, by the way.
That was our only
number one hit.
Number one hit.
Very few rock stars have a rebirth in their 40s.
Yeah.
And you did.
Mm-hmm.
And it wasn't just a rebirth, but you introduced Aerosmith to a brand new audience, the MTV audience.
Mm-hmm.
How improbable that is, that a bunch of 40-year-old dudes could do that.
We've been on tour for 49 years.
That's amazing.
On tour.
I think the second act was almost bigger than the first act.
I think you're right. It was. We got sober and we were willing to sit. I was willing to sit with people that said, you know, I got this rough idea, and write with not just Joe and not just with myself, but write with a few other people. I'd never done that in my whole life. That was the second coming. Crying, for instance, was a guy named Taylor Rhodes from down south. And, you know, I said, you know, how about dun, 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 in the beginning? And we wrote this song called Crying, one of our biggest hits. So that was it, but how odd. You're so right that a bunch of 40-year-old guys could turn on to, because I don't think any bands were doing that. It's just like, I keep looking around left and right when we're on stage and thinking, these guys really love what they're doing.
Rick Rubin was very important. Well, that was a huge thing.
No, Rick Rubin was a genius. He was the one to break through the wall of rock to rap. And I'm not sure if they liked Aerosmith, really, really. Rick turned them on to the beat, and they did it, but they had their own lyrics.
Surely it's all.
We make a record with Aerosmith, y'all.
Did you realize what you were getting into with Run-DMC?
No, when I found that they were doing that, Joe and I got on a plane, we were on tour, and went down to see Rick. And we heard what they were doing, and I went, can I go in and sing with them while they're singing? And Joe said, I think maybe I should play too. And we merged that together, and that was the end of it.
You guys have played, I think, 12,000 concerts. Maybe more. But at a point, you sing the same songs over and over and over again. Does it get old?
Hence, drugs. You get it now.
I never thought of that.
It's interesting. When I look at myself in the old days, it's like I'm just like standing there like this, and I'm so high. Now I have a ramp. I run all over the place. I grab people. I talk. You know, so we have fun. And something else, I have in-ears. And in-ears means Amy and Travis, who worked me on stage, Travis does my in-ear mix, and Amy's my lover. She'll say, look at that girl with a wooden leg over there. So they'll be talking to me.
Oh, you're kidding. So you get stage props? Oh,
I get prompts. I get talked to. I get told, look at that girl. She's flashing, you know. I get told a ton of stuff.
Hey, Amy, can you come here for a second?
Amy! Map, 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 map.
So, yes. So Steven just said that you talk in his ear during the concerts.
Yeah.
I want to know, do you ever screw with him when he's...
Oh, you have no idea.
Yeah, but I've never done, like, a joke, because he's out of his freaking mind and totally on another planet, so it would be dangerous to be like...
We ran into each other in Israel. I was in Tel Aviv, actually, doing this show, and you were doing a concert.
But you were doing it with Netanyahu?
That's right. And we ran into each other at a restaurant. I don't know if you remember this, but Everybody noticed you, obviously, and they played one of your songs. And you were doing air guitar, you were singing at the table, and you seemed so happy. And I thought, God, after all these years, he gets a charge out of it still. I was really moved by that.
I do get a joy out of it. I like it. I feel like things people feel, you know, I can feel it inside. I can see it in their eyes, like their mannerisms. So when the waiters and waitresses come up and they act a certain way, it's like, I'm yours. I'm yours.
It was really apparent, and it was great.
Yeah. Oh, good. I'm glad you saw that.
I remember you once said, and it struck me so, that the front row is my family when you were at concerts. And I found that interesting because you had a real family.
I was high, didn't pay a lot of attention to my family, and it's just one of those things you pay for.
Finally, partner, our own office. Selfie?
Yeah.
Okay, desk in the background.